Hello, people of the internet. My name is AJ, and I'm going to do a thing. We're back playing Fire Emblem Three Houses. This is the final battle. We have just completed it. We are going to continue the story and end it, apparently, without many of our characters.
You're here, Mother.
Okay, I assumed the cutscene would continue a little bit longer. Let's save our progress.
A rising flame was alight as the flow of time carved a new history for Fodlan. Rhea's wild rampage was put to an end, averting what could have been the greatest crisis in the history of Fodlan. After 5.5 years of war, a new age was set to begin. The Empire, Kingdom, and Alliance, all political structures that had once shaped the continent, were gone. A unified nation began to take shape under the watchful eye of the Church of Saros. The Church's new leader became a champion of the people, working tirelessly to help them overcome the horrors of war and to carve out a path towards reconstruction. Just as Saint Saros tended to those who suffered in wars of the past, Fodlan's new ruler embraced their role as mother of all life and arbiter of every soul.
Welp, this has been one heck of a game, my goodness.
Professor, I...
done what we can.
We have. I can feel that the crests are no longer a part of me.
She lives!
That must mean I'll... I mean, my body will...
Can't say for sure, but we can hope.
Thank you, Professor. No matter the outcome, I feel a sense of peace. I have hope, and that hope will carry me through it all. You've done so much, searching for a way to remove my crest, to save me. I can't tell you how much it means to me.
So, now what will you do?
I will not claim my title. House Ordelia will end with my father's generation. After this, I'm going to begin preparations for our family's dissolution. This will ensure that the people of our territory will not be troubled, and my parents will be able to live out their lives in peace.
And after that?
A good question. I hadn't considered it, but assuming I have life left in me, would it be all right if I came back here to stay by your side? Without my crests, I'm not sure what all I'd be able to do for you. But You have given me a new life. I want to use my time to support you however I can. I just...
Lysithia, I want you to have this. Oh, I'm giving her the ring!
Oh, is this... This is...
I'll be waiting for your safe return.
What I said earlier, about not caring what the outcome of all this is, I take it back. For the longest time, I didn't think I'd be around to be a part of the future you and everyone were creating. That I had no place in it. But now, I cannot fight it any longer. I do care, and I do not wish to give up on chasing that future. I do not wish to die. I refuse to give up on myself or on our future. And so, I promise to come back to you, no matter what. Once I'm back,
we will chase the future together.
Yes, I quite like the sound of that. Together. It is decided. We will be together forever, living long, full lives. Count on it, my love.
But I married you as a friend. I married you so you wouldn't die. That's honestly the reason. And so many other people died, my goodness. Look at all the data. Oh, I can't believe Dimitri was our MVP and we never even did anything. Edelgard was our MVP. Me. Oh, we stopped using Anna a while ago. Lynn. Oh, Lynn. Edelgard. What a journey we've been on. What a journey this game has been. This battle. This game has been breathtakingly beautiful. Doroth, you know. I enjoyed this game so much, let me just say. Hubert, get out. Doroth, you know. This was a lot of fun, and I do intend to play Dimitri's Path eventually. I don't know when that's going to be, and I have no idea. I have no idea what game I'm going to play next. I'm probably just going to continue competitive battling with Pokemon. So if we married Lysithia in the last game she would have lived, that kind of hurts. I wish I just knew that. I would have married her immediately, just because I needed her to live. Even though Raphael died, Dorothea died, Lynn died, at least Lysithia lived. They all lived last game, probably. Raphael definitely did. You know what? We may have killed Dorothea. Honestly, part of me is really surprised that Bernie made it all the way. She was not doing too great, but she did it. I just can't believe everything this game has done. Every amazing turn, every move, it all led here to the end, and man, what a legacy. What a time. Of course, Lysithia was the MVP. No shocker to anyone. Now tell us what happened to the rest of our students, please. Constance. For her service in the war and her innovations in magic, Constance von received leader of the magic research and development. Oh, cool. Well, that's fun. Catherine. She left the Knights of Seros and set out to travel across Flirtland. Flirtland with Thunderbrand, she wandered the countryside, seeking always to defend the innocent and punish the wicked. Her many years, heroic, beloved folk hero. That's not what I expect from... I think that is kind of what I expect from Catherine, actually. Alois. All the fighting has come to an end. Chrissy took up position as the captain of the Knights of Seros. He was much beloved. It is said that he accomplished more. Oh, even beyond what Gerald's troop had achieved. That's outstanding, my dude. That is outstanding. Blaine disappeared soon after the war, and over time, it was all but forgotten that she had existed. Many years later, however, a young woman completely surfaced in the transformed Foland. She looked for a man, which he would find. Where to call her father? I obviously read that really wrong. I'm not wearing my glasses, I'm just trying to read. You joined? Cool. Quickly took up a leadership role. Bladebreaker. Gerald II. Oh. Including his drinking habit. Left behind many unpaid tavern tabs. Well, that's not good. That's not good, Leone. Ignat! After returning home, persuaded his family he should become a painter, travel all throughout Fernland and beyond, painted beautiful landscapes and captivating portraits of the world's cultures. His unique style. Ignatz, I'm so proud of you. I know we didn't use you in this game, but last game you were a major player. Lorenz, soon after the war, he assumed leadership over House Gloucester, helped Fodland as a representative of the old Alliance lords. Political talents yielded revolutionary policy changes, many of which were particularly benefit to the Confolks. That's character growth. That is a lot of character growth. Annette returned to her hometown. Teaching position at the Royal School of Sorcery, she was a gifted instructor, and many of her students went on to become world-renowned sages. Through her talents for teaching was remarkable on its own, she perhaps best remembered for effortlessly securing like new students by living a life of kindness, cheer, and humility. Sigh. Unable to serve Rael any longer, Sigh nearly left the church, persuaded to stay. Built the monastery, thanks to devoted work, the Officer's Academy was able to reopen it a few years later. I found himself. Oh, he was a student. Maybe, I think. After the war, Hilda set politics aside and focused on what she enjoyed. Crafting fashion accessories, okay. With the help of her brother, Hilda then created the first Artisan Academy in Fodley, where she served as both professor and headmaster. Shamir. Shortly after the war, Shamir gave up the mercenary life and disappeared. Never heard from again. Rumors persisted. Master Archer turned thief who lined her pockets by shaking down all those who preyed upon the incident. That is a good story. Sylvain. Sylvain devoted his life to improving relationships with the people of that region. With orientate with Ration alone, he though he went to history never to refer to Jesus as sons of Gautier. Oh, Sylvain, your legacy. He remained at the monastery and worked to restore authority in the Church of Theros. Doing this with full strictness, he adopted a tolerant stance. All respect those of other faiths who helped people of Fodland find common ground with others. Orath fell in the battle. Oh, that's all it says? Well, he did fall in the battle, I guess. That's heartbreaking. Oh, what? What's happening here? After the war, Marianne and Hanneman stayed in touch and deepened their friendship through letters. When Hanneman's crest research fell in hard times, Marianne was able to secure Mulgrave Edmund's financial support to allow needed work, research more fruit, and the magical tools. The funding allowed tools a great number. After Marianne inherited her adopted father's house, he guided Hanneman to create a branch of research devoted to peaceful application of Christology. Advancements Hanneman provided became the legacy of Marianne's. Oh my goodness. Still price selling stuff, Anna's business savvy, a great asset post-war reconstruction of Yerrig Mach. Once the restoration was complete, she disappeared from the area entirely. Some say she continues her travels throughout the state, eternally peddling her wares, never in search of her next lucrative opportunity. Petra! Petra returned to the homeland, inherited from the throne from her grandfather, declared independence, worked tirelessly, restored the relationship between Ferdinand and Dagda, torches lit, secured the future of peace and prosperity for her people. Nice. Lynn, dead. Oh my goodness. We're gonna see Dorothea too. That's just heartbreaking. Seeing everyone we lost. My goodness. 333. Oh man. Cass, my guy. After the war, Cass set out alone. Self-discovery. Every corner of Fjordland. Said that he got into mischief at every turn, but that the victims of his antics, always more amused than harmed or offended, remembered him fondly, and he passed those stories on to future generations. They passed those books. Okay. Interesting. Even after the war ends, skirmishes continued to break out across Fjordland, learning that there were still places where he could fight. Felix abandoned his noble title. Makes sense. Unwilling to leave his Ingrid, relinquished her claim to nobility. Both became wandering mercenaries. They skirted the line between life and death. Dangerous. They had one child, but once they had a child, they settled down. They began a warm and tranquil life as a family. Okay, that's interesting. Bernadette renounced her claim. She married Ferdinand, Duke of Eyre. Due to the success of the policies, Ferdinand was offered an opportunity to help govern all of Fjordland. He accepted, leaving the management of the Eyre territory to his wife. While he Bernadetta did not like to leave home, same. Okay. AJ announces again engagement to Lysithia shortly after becoming the leader of the United Kingdom of Fjordland. Before they were officially wed, she returned home, helped her father restore the Ordelia territory, and offered land to buy the new kingdom. Ordelia, in order, Lysithia finally married and became queen. Even without request, she proved to be a capable. That's right, I know. Rebuilding efforts with the couple and their children enjoyed long and peaceful lives. What a game. What a game. Game was so much fun. I honestly wish it didn't have to end. I wish I could still continue playing. I wish there was another... I wish there was another chapter. I wish there was another, like, 10 chapters, honestly. Can't believe my favorite student died. I'll never get over it. It'll haunt me. We're just gonna watch all of these. I refuse to skip them. At this point, this entire game has led to watching the credits, honestly. And I just, you know, this was such a game. It was wonderful. It was heartbreaking. It had a good story. I mean, I understand there's an entire fandom of Fire Emblem. There's an entire Fire Emblem fandom that does not enjoy this game. But honestly, I had a lot of fun. Someone who doesn't play all the Fire Emblem games, it was a lot of fun, and I just, gosh, I really like this game, and I really hope everyone else who played it enjoyed it. It would be really interesting to see if they could make a sequel for this game, or a prequel, I guess, would be more appropriate, because all stories lead to this story, or lead to the main character, lead to Byleth doing the dang thing, saving Fjordland. That would be interesting. What a game. What a game. It's been a long journey. It's been a long, long journey. But it's done. Can't believe it's done. Maybe the next game I will not have any problems when I'm recording. Doubt it, but knowing me, I'm gonna have a problem. Maybe I'll play a Pokemon hack next. I've been thinking about that. You know what? I'm gonna stop talking. We're just gonna enjoy the music. Also, I know there's a YouTube video series of the voice of Claude playing Fire Emblem Three Houses, which I'm probably going to watch after this. I'm very excited about it. I think it'll be an entirely new... I mean, everyone playing Fire Emblem plays it with, like, different things in mind. And I'm really excited to see it, honestly. Not advertisement, but I'm going to watch it. Still, we have Dimitri's story to go to. Can't believe we still have Dimitri's story to go. It's been so long. I've been playing this game, or at least the Fire Emblem, either a Golden Deer or Black Eagle for over a year, honestly. I mean, I've obviously taken like 3 breaks, I think, but still, it's been a long time. And there's still so much story I haven't delved into on. I mean, there's so much growing that I've done as a person. Like, in the middle of playing this game, I built a new computer. I got a new microphone. Maybe not when I was playing this game. Maybe when I was playing a different game, I got the new microphone. I got a mic stand. Well, maybe not a stand, it's called a spider mount thing. I don't know what it's called. I streamed for the first time. I still have the same job I had when I started this game, but I'm much better at it. Man, what a game. This game gone on for so long. So happy. Genuinely, I understand that people on YouTube, like, the average person is not going to sit through and watch every single episode of me playing Fire Emblem, but you know what? This was such a fun game. Like, genuinely. I just hope everyone who plays it enjoys it just as much as I did. Hopefully they do not lose their favorite character in the final battle. That could have easily been avoided. Oh, your club coat. I got new headphones. I can watch Blu-ray DVDs on my computer, which is cool. So much has changed in my life from when I started playing this game. Before I was playing this game, COVID was not in the United States. Before I was playing it the first time, I'm pretty sure there was no COVID in the US. Or maybe there was a few cases. It wasn't as bad as it is now, arguably. It definitely wasn't as bad as it is now. I don't think I've mentioned COVID on this channel before. It's a very touchy subject for everyone, including me, honestly. With what I do, I see a lot of things. Too many things, honestly. But playing video games, it helps me forget about it. Like, if I didn't have video games, I would just, like, be sad over it. Like, I'm still obviously sad over COVID. But I would be a lot more sad if I didn't, if I wasn't able to just, like, sit down, play a game, and just distract myself, honestly. Because I think that's what video games do. It helps you distract yourself from the real world. Or at least that's what it does for me. The real world is crazy. Video games are a lot less so. Maybe not extremely, but definitely a lot. I mean, everyone who made this game should be so proud of themselves. This game has been breathtakingly magnificent in every single way. The characters all had unique arcs, which was wonderful. The voice acting was phenomenal. The music, honestly, the music in this game, definitely probably the best music I've ever heard in a video game. That I can think of off the top of my head. But to be fair, I'm playing the game right now, so. Who else deserves a lot of the credit? Whoever hired the voice actors deserves so much credit. I didn't really look at the name. I'm trying to deal with the fact that this game is over. At least this story of the game is over. The game isn't over. The game is never over. Because we can always just play it again with different characters. And that's honestly one of the coolest things about it. I do not want it to... I do not want my screen to dim. Whoever had the idea of this game, I really hope... I mean, everyone involved, I just hope you know how wonderful the game was. This game was magnificent in every way. It was wonderful. It made me feel so many things, but above all, it made me feel happy. And honestly, this game, it's amazing. The end. Man, what a journey it's been. What a journey. You know what? I enjoyed every single minute, except when Raphael died. That's what I didn't enjoy. I imagine Lynn would have been a Crest Scholar and Dorothea would have. I don't know. I don't know what I'd imagine Dorothea doing. What would Dorothea do? Everyone who made this game deserves so much credit. They deserve so many props. Thank you for making this wonderful game, and thank you for letting me enjoy it. Letting everyone enjoy it. Thank you for your legacy. And I think that'll be the end of this playthrough, actually. And, I mean, I'll see you guys next time with whatever we're playing.